Abel, there's a lot of talk this week with him being on Max Kellerman's show saying that if Floyd says it's easy work, to show him it's easy work. Now, is that fight realistic at all, or are you kind of just knowing it's more just talk and propaganda at this point?
You know, I think that Floyd is a hell of a businessman, and he has proven to all of us that he makes decisions and he talks when he talks for a reason. He's been mentioning Golovkin, maybe he has in mind. I don't know, I'm not in Floyd's head, but from day one, Golovkin's always said that his dream fight was against Floyd. Mine was against Chavez. If Floyd decides that he wants that, that's that challenge that you're talking about, okay? He wants the challenge, he wants to move up and challenge 160 pounder. And for Floyd, we will drop down 154 because I think Floyd deserves that. Canelo doesn't deserve that. Floyd deserves that because of what he's done. He would drop down 154. Now, we'd be given an advantage of Floyd, but I think that's the kind of fight that it would be interesting. It'd be interesting. I don't know, could he have the power that he had today? Maybe not.
So as a trainer, when you think about that fight, how do you envision it playing out and what happens at the end?
You know, I see a decision. I see a decision just because Floyd is such a master at what he does. I see a decision because we're going to drop down 6 pounds and give him a slight advantage. Maybe the power won't be there, but I see Floyd doing what Floyd does and it being the kind of fight that could happen twice.
Hard to imagine Gennady's power wouldn't be there even as
well. Well, you know, 6 pounds is a lot. You saw Chocolatito today. Yeah. Chocolatito is struggling to make 112. And the snap, he was pushing his punches, the aggression wasn't there. Weight does a lot to these guys.
Mm-hmm. How special is Gennady, Abel? I mean, from what you work with a lot of fighters, how special is he and how special is he going to be remembered after it's all said and done?
I went to high school with a guy named Robert Morales, who you guys all know. Mm-hmm. And 9 months after Gennady walked into my gym, I said, right now, he's the best fighter I've ever worked with. I got one in the Hall of Fame. Terry Norris is in the Hall of Fame. This guy is twice the fighter Terry was ever at 9 months. Today we saw a little more unveiling of some of the things that he does in the gym. He wanted to attack today. He wanted to go after this guy. And then when it got too easy, he put his face out there again. You know, it just bugs the hell out of me, but there's nothing I can do about that.
Hey, but go ahead, finish.
I said it 4 or 5 years ago, this guy's going to go down to one of the best middleweights of all times. It's just a matter of hopefully he doesn't get to be 45 before any of these guys want to fight him.
Is that a real concern for you guys?
No. No, he unifies the belts and he breaks Hopkins' record. I think that'll place him up there somewhere.